2 weeks after Boracay Island was officially closed to the public, the government is now on a damage control mode. That's according to Guenter Taus, president of the European Chamber of Commerce Philippines.
From a reputation point of view, certainly not a good reputation that we get abroad with what has been done.
Taus also asserts newly appointed Tourism Secretary Bernadette Romulo Puyat can only do so much to mitigate the impact of Boracay's closure.
I don't think there will be any impact because it was not a decision that was made by the Tourism Secretary, old or new, incoming or outgoing. It was an executive decision. So I think for the local market as well as for the international, even more so for the international crowd, it would not make a difference who is at the helm of the department at this point in time.
But Taus explains the new tourism chief should step up.
A six-month closure will certainly not change much, if anything at all. So we are in damage control mode, and I think so should the Department of Tourism get out the message that after a couple of months, Boracay will be open again and it will be much cleaner. And we have a lot of alternatives in the Visayas.
For his part, Budget Secretary Ben Diokno admits Boracay's rehabilitation might continue until next year.
Sometimes when you ask for maybe long term, like like the relocation of some of the informal settlers, that might spill over to next year.
But Diokno clarifies the government will open the island again on or before the 6 month deadline. Meanwhile, Taus explains despite Boracay's closure, the tourism industry in Visayas could still thrive thanks to other attractions in the region, especially Cebu.
It seems to be very positive for Cebu and for the Visayas in general that Boracay was closed down because the numbers are rising. And if you look at last year, Cebu had about top the list of tourists with about 2.7 million that were recorded here. And it looks like the numbers are rising.
Taus adds the ECCP is hands-on in promoting Cebu for tourism and investment. He is confident this would generate more jobs in the region, as over 36,000 workers have been displaced by Boracay's shutdown.
Because we started putting together different packages that can actually be offered using Cebu as a hub for tourism coming in from Europe. And since we'll be out in a mission again soon in Europe, we would like to present those packages to tour operators and see and convince them that the Visayas is as good as Boracay.
Data from the tourism department show about 6.6 million tourists visited the Philippines in 2017, of which around 2 million went to Boracay Island.